We say that we actually have a lot of information about the console. Sure, we still don't know about the price, but we know so much about the console that we're actually looking forward to launch day. There are many reasons to get excited about the PS5, whether it's the exclusives, the SSD, or the incredible hardware under the hood. Whatever the case may be, we're just as excited as you. So let's take a look at all the reasons why you should pick up a PS5 at launch day. Exclusive games. Let's be honest, the main reason why you're considering getting a PS5 in the first place is because of those games. Considering the PS4 had much better exclusives than the Xbox One, you have plenty of reasons to be excited about all the incredible PS5 exclusives we've seen so far. As you know, games are the most important selling point for a console. If you have amazing games, then you get sales. It's as simple as that, and Sony is well aware of it. On PS5, we'll be getting 9 exclusives at or shortly after launch. Those games include Astro's Playroom, Demon's Souls, Destruction All-Stars, Gran Turismo 7, Horizon Forbidden West, Marvel's Spider-Man Miles Morales, Ratchet & Clank Rift Apart, Returnal, and Sackboy: A Big Adventure. All of these games will take advantage of the tech inside the PS5, and looked great at the June reveal event. We're most excited for Horizon Forbidden West and Spider-Man Miles Morales, and hope they continue from where they left off on PS4. But what games are you most excited for? Let us know in the comments. SSD. As we saw in the Ratchet & Clank Rift Apart gameplay trailer, the solid-state drive on the PS5 is unlike anything we've ever seen in a console. Capable of loading entire worlds in sheer milliseconds. Considering how we're so used to loading screens at this point, it's going to be a huge generational leap to get rid of them entirely. Seriously, just the thought of loading screens disappearing from open-world games has us jumping for joy. Now for the specs of the SSD, the PS5 will be using a custom 825GB solid-state drive, which is a very odd amount of storage since we expected at least a terabyte. But hey, Sony knows what they're doing because those read and write speeds are something else. In fact, the PS5's SSD blows the Series X right out of the water. It's capable of 5.5 to 9 gigabytes per second speeds, which is blazing fast, even for a solid-state drive. On the other hand, the Xbox Series X's SSD is much less impressive as it's only capable of 2.4 to 6 gigabytes per second. What this means is that games should load quite a bit faster on the PS5 compared to the Series X, hopefully eliminating loading screens for good. We're not gonna miss them, that's for sure. DualSense. The new DualSense controller is another reason why you should get the PS5 at launch. It looks like the best one yet. The DualSense will support haptic feedback, which will add a variety of powerful sensations we'll feel when we play. Sony mentioned the slow grittiness of driving a car through mud as something that we'll feel through haptic feedback. So Gran Turismo 7 should really showcase this feature. The controller will also have adaptive triggers in the L2 and R2 buttons, which will allow us to truly feel the tension of our actions. Sony highlighted drawing a bow to shoot an arrow as something we'll be able to feel through adaptive triggers, so Horizon Forbidden West could really showcase this when Aloy uses her bow and arrow. The share button has been replaced with the create button on the DualSense that'll be used to stream, take pictures, and record video clips. The controller also comes with a built-in microphone that could be used to communicate with teammates, although for longer sessions, a headset is definitely recommended. It even comes with a 3.5mm headphone jack as well as USB-C support instead of micro USB, which is a huge step forward. We don't know anything about battery life yet, but we sure hope the DualSense lasts longer than the DualShock 4. That controller was basically a wired one. Visuals. Graphics have always been one of the most important aspects of gaming, but if you expect to see a huge difference between visuals on the PS4 and PS5, then you might be disappointed. Sure, games will definitely look better on the PS5, but it won't be a huge leap like, say, PS2 to PS3. Still, we do expect PS5 graphics to get better over time, just like with the PS4. Take a game that came out in 2014 on the PS4 and compare it to a game like The Last of Us Part 2. The difference is night and day. On top of these incremental graphical improvements, we'll be seeing improved and more consistent frame rates. Developers will try to make 60 FPS the minimum frame rate for their games, with 120 FPS being the ultimate goal. We'll also be seeing more native 4K resolutions instead of the tricks the PS4 Pro is using. One of the most exciting new features has to be ray tracing, which will significantly improve lighting and the way it bounces off of objects and shapes. While it might not be a huge generational leap, visuals will certainly be improved on the PS5. Digital Edition. Sony surprised everyone at the June reveal event when they announced that not one, but two PS5 consoles would be released during the holiday season of 2020. The standard PS5 with a Blu-ray disc drive and the PS5 Digital Edition. Unlike Microsoft's Xbox Series X that at this moment only has one option with a disk drive, Sony decided to give gamers who buy all their games digitally an option as well. Not only does the digital edition look more symmetrical than the standard PS5, which is a big deal for those with OCD, it'll also be less expensive, which is huge for gamers on a budget. Now, since we don't know the price of the PS5 yet, it's all just rumors right now, but the PS5 Digital Edition may only be $50 cheaper than the standard PS5, which is pretty disappointing, actually. If it was $100 cheaper, that's a really good deal, but $50 isn't a whole lot of money saved. 3D audio. A feature that may have flown a bit under the radar is 3D audio. Despite the PS4 having amazing audio already, it was far from perfect, according to Sony. They believe the engine in the PS3 worked much better, so they tried to make one more similar to that in the PS5. They could have gone with Dolby Atmos, but decided to make their own 3D audio engine, called Tempest 3D Audio Tech, so they could focus on creating excellent audio for all the different setups players use, including TV speakers, headphones, a soundbar, surround sound, and more. 3D audio is mainly going to help players with locality. There'll be 5 different tuning options available with the console at launch. Picking the best one for your own unique hearing situation will make it easier to track exactly where sound is coming from, instead of just knowing its general direction. In fact, the sound is supposedly going to be so realistic that you may think it's actually coming from the real world, which is kinda trippy, but we're down to get fully immersed in next-gen gaming. Expandable storage. We touched a little bit on PS5 storage already, but let's take a more in-depth look at all the storage options we have with the console. Of course, you have the 825GB solid-state drive that comes with the console, well, that's a given, but you also have a good amount of expandable storage options. Yes, even though the console comes with a solid-state drive, you can plug an external hard drive into the console. Of course, it could only be used for PS4 games, but it's an option for you if you don't want to re-download all your PS4 games onto your PlayStation 5's SSD. The console will also come with a built-in expansion bay for an additional solid-state drive. Now, you can't just grab any solid-state drive on the market and install it in your PS5. It's not gonna work like that. The PS5 will only be compatible with certain M.2 SSDs, and Sony will eventually release a list of which ones are compatible with the console. Storage is one of the areas where the Series X has Sony beat with its 1TB solid-state drive, but this expansion bay makes that difference a much smaller deal. Improved CPU and GPU. Of course, all those improvements wouldn't be possible without the incredibly powerful CPU and GPU in the PS5. The hardware inside the PS4 was far from impressive and became outdated fairly early in the console's life cycle. On the other hand, the hardware inside the PS5 is a huge step up, and is more similar to a gaming PC than the PS4 ever was. As for the specs of the CPU and GPU, the PS5 will feature a custom 8-core AMD Zen 2 CPU, clocked at a variable frequency, and a custom GPU based on AMD's RDNA 2 architecture capable of producing 10.28 teraflops, clocked at a variable frequency. Virtual reality. Okay, it might be a bit odd to bring up virtual reality since Sony hasn't said a peep about it in what feels like forever, but it's still worth mentioning. While the PSVR 2 headset may not be launching alongside the PS5, if you're into VR, it's never really too early to get prepared. And you could do that by getting the PlayStation 5 at launch. By doing just that, when PSVR 2 does eventually come out, you'll already have a PS5, so you'll be ready to go. Plus, it's going to be compatible with the first generation PSVR anyway, so you could still use that headset if need be. Head start on next gen. While most of our entries have focused on specific PS5 features, honestly, isn't it? I really think so. The PS5's features are incredible, and we live in the generation of instant gratification, so who the heck has the patience to twiddle their thumbs and wait for the right time when you could buy a PS5 immediately at launch? We sure don't. We want to take advantage of all the PS5's features on day one, and that's exactly what we're gonna do. Bonus, backwards compatibility. You thought we were done? Oh no, we got a bonus entry to get into, and that's backwards compatibility. Initially, it seems like another area where the Xbox Series X has the PS5 beat, but is it as important as everyone is making it out to be? We don't really think so. If you think about it, backwards compatibility is only really important for year one, and most people are only going to want to play PS4 games on PS5 anyway, so it's not that big of a deal if they can't play PS1, PS2, or PS3 games on the console as well. Microsoft may just be playing it up as being more important than it actually is to get sales by focusing their marketing on the areas where their console is better than the PS5. Plus, there's a recent patent leak that indicates we might actually get PS1, PS2, and PS3 backwards compatibility on the PS5. So, Sony...